Hello friends, welcome to my channel only for civil engineers. In this video we will discuss about bonds in brickworks, that is types of bonds. Before starting this video I would like to tell you that if you want to notes related to the subject building construction and materials with the pictorial format like this presentation, then link is given in the description box. These notes are helpful for various competitive exams like RRBJE, SSCJE, State PSC, PSUs and also helpful for semester exams. Now we will start today's video. So firstly we will see types of bonds. So there are varieties of bonds used for different types of works, and these types of bonds are stretcher bond, header bond, English bond, Flemish bond, garden wall bond and raking bond. So in this video we will discuss all these types of bonds one by one in detail. So firstly we will discuss about stretcher bond. In this type of bond, all the bricks are laid with their lanes in the direction of the wall. So in this image we can see this is direction of wall, this is also direction of wall, and here we can see all the bricks are laid with their length in the direction of this wall. So this is stretcher bond. So this image shows stretcher bond. This pattern is used only for walls having thickness of half brick, that is 9 cm. Example of this stretcher bond is walls in the case of frame structure construction. Now we will see second type of bond, that is header bond. In this type of bond, all the bricks are laid with their ends towards the face of the wall. So here we can see this is face of wall and here this is end of bricks. These are the ends of bricks. So in the header bond, all the bricks are laid with their ends towards the face of wall. So this image shows header bond. This type of arrangement is suitable for walls which are one brick thick. So in the case of header bond, thickness of wall is one brick thick. This is suitable for walls of lightly loaded load bearing structures. Now we will see third type of bond, that is English bond. So English bond is most common and popular bond, and it is used for wall thickness ranging from 20 cm and above. English bond contains of equal balancing of headers and stretchers in the wall. That is, headers and stretchers are arranged in the alternate courses. So this image shows elevation of English bond. Here we can see this course contains all the stretchers. Next course contains all the headers. Then next course contains all the stretchers. So like that, in the English bond, headers and stretchers are arranged in the alternate courses. English bond construction requires the following points to be kept in view. First point is, a queen closure must be provided after the quoin header, and a header course should never start with a queen closure. So in this image we can see this is quoin header. Okay, this is quoin header, and after this quoin header queen closure is provided. So after this quoin header queen closure must be provided. And header course should never start with this queen closure, because header course start with this quoin header. Also, continuous vertical joint should not be allowed in the English bond. So in this English bond we can see these are vertical joints. So in the English bond, these vertical joint should not allowed in continuous. Okay, so these joints are discontinuous. Now next point is, the joints in the header course should be made thinner than those in the stretcher course. This is because of the fact that the number of vertical joints in the stretcher course is half of the number of joints in the header course, as shown in this image. In the stretcher course, the stretchers should have a minimum lap of 1/4 of their length over the headers. So this is stretcher's course, and here we can see this is 1/4, minimum lap is 1/4. in the stretcher course of their length over the headers. Now, next type of bond is Flemish bond. In this type of bond, brickwork of each course consists of alternate headers and stretchers as shown in this image. So, in this image, we can see this course contains headers, stretchers, headers, stretchers. Then another course also contains headers, stretchers, headers, stretchers. So, in the Flemish bond, each course consists of alternate headers and stretchers. Every alternate course starts with a header at the corner as shown in this image. There are mainly two types of Flemish bond. First one is single Flemish bond and second one is double Flemish bond. Now we will see these two types of Flemish bond one by one. So firstly, we will discuss about single Flemish bond. So combination of English bond and Flemish bond resulting into new type of bond, and it is called as single Flemish bond. So in this image we can see this is single Flemish bond. This is facing of this single Flemish bond. This is backing of the single Flemish bond. So here on the facing of the wall there is a Flemish bond, and on the backing of this single Flemish bond there is English bond in each course. For the purpose of attractive appearance of wall, this bond is mainly adopted. But drawback of this single Flemish bond is that it cannot be used for walls less than 1.5 brick in thickness. So this image shows single Flemish bond, where this first image shows odd courses and second image shows even courses. Now we will see double Flemish bond. So double Flemish bond is a typical type of Flemish bond in which there is same appearance in each course can be seen in the front face and in the back face. So in short, the appearance of the wall on facing and backing side is same in each course as shown in this image. Okay. Side header and stretchers are laid in each course alternately. Double Flemish bond shows the better looking or better appearance than English bond. So this image shows double Flemish bond. This first image shows odd courses and second image shows even courses. Now we will discuss about features of double Flemish bond. Since double Flemish bond is a typical bond, so it has some special features. And first feature is headers and stretchers are laid in each course alternately. Second feature is the appearance of the wall on facing and backing is same in each course. Next feature is there is a maximum or ample use of half bricks, half bats, quarters bats and 3/4 brick bats in wall thickness. Coin closures are laid next to coin headers in each alternate course. So here we can see this is coin closure and this is coin header. So coin closure are next to coin headers in each alternate course. Next type of bond is garden wall bond. So garden wall bond is specially used for the construction of garden wall, boundary wall, compound wall. Height of wall in the case of such bond should not exceed 2 meter and thickness of the wall is 1 brick thick. As like English bond, garden wall bond is not strong but it is more elegant and attractive, and therefore it is sometimes used in the outer leaves construction of cavity walls. There are three types of garden wall bond. First one is garden wall Flemish bond. Second one is garden wall English bond. And third one is garden wall monk bond. Now we will see all these three types of garden wall bond one by one. So firstly we will discuss about garden wall Flemish bond, and it is also known as Scotch bond. So when each course is made up of one header after 3 to 5 stretchers as shown in this image, which are placed continuously throughout the length of the course, then it is termed as garden wall Flemish bond. So this image shows elevation of garden wall Flemish bond, and here we can see this is header, After this header, we can see there are provided three stretchers. After these three stretchers, again provided header. So like that, after 3 to 5 stretcher, there is provided one header in each course. So this is garden wall Flemish bond, and this garden wall Flemish bond is also known as Scotch bond. 3/4 brick bat is placed very next to quine header in each alternate course, so as to provide necessary lap. So here, this one is quine header, and after this quine header, 3/4 brick bat is provided in each alternate course, so as to provide necessary lap. So remember, this is quine header and this is 3/4 brick bat. A header is laid over the middle of each central stretcher. So here we can see this one is stretcher. Okay, this one is stretcher, and here we can see header is provided. Header is laid over the middle of each central stretchers as shown in this image. This type of bond is also termed as Scotch bond or Sussex bond. Now we will see second type of garden wall bond, and which is garden wall English bond. So in this type of bond, header course is provided only after 3 to 5 stretcher course. So here we can see this first course contains all the headers, then next course contains all the stretchers. Okay, next course contains stretchers. So after this header, continuously 3 course contains stretchers. After these 3 stretchers courses, here we can see this course contains headers. So in the garden wall English bond, header course is provided only after 3 to 5 stretcher courses. So this is garden wall English bond, and here quine closure is provided in each header course next to quine header, so as to have the necessary lap. So here we can see this is header course, and here we can see this is quine closure. So quine closure is provided in each header course next to quine header. So this is quine header. This one is quine header, and after this quine header, quine closure is provided in each header course. Okay, so this similar to for this header course also. So quine headers are provided in stretcher courses alternately. So we can see this is stretcher course, this is also stretcher course, this is also stretcher course. So here we can see this is quine headers. So quine headers are provided here, it's also quine headers are provided in each stretcher courses alternatively. Now third type of garden wall bond is garden wall monk bond. When each course is made up of one header after 2 successive stretchers, then it is termed as garden wall monk bond. So in this image we can see this is elevation of garden wall monk bond, and here we can see this course contains 2 stretcher. After this 2 stretcher, there is header. After this header, we can see 2 stretchers, then again header. So in the garden wall monk bond, each course is made up of one header after 2 successive stretchers. So this is garden wall monk bond, and this is repeat for all the courses. It is one of the special type of garden wall Flemish bond. A quine header followed by 3/4 brick bat, it is provided in each alternate courses, and therefore the header rests over joined between 2 successive stretchers. Now last type of bond is raking bond. So raking means inclination. When the bond in which Bricks are laid at an inclination to the direction of the wall. Then it is termed as racking bond. So in this image we can see this is the direction of wall. This is direction of bond. And when bond in which bricks are laid at an inclination to this direction of wall, it is known as racking bond. So this is direction of wall, and here we can see these bonds in which bricks are laid at an inclination to this direction of this wall, this is racking bond. This type of bond is used in thick wall. Longitudinal stability of wall is more in the case of racking bond, and therefore if such type of bond is provided in thick wall of English bond, the longitudinal stability of English bond gets increased. So there are two types of racking bond. First one is diagonal bond and second one is herringbone bond. So now we will see these two types of racking bond one by one. So firstly we will discuss about diagonal bond. So in such type of racking bond, the bricks are laid at an inclination of 45 degree in such a way that the extreme end corners of diagonal course remains in contact with the external line of stretchers. At the end of this diagonal course, bricks are cut in a triangular shape and suitable sizes by mason with the help of steel trowel, and these bricks are packed at the ends of the diagonal course. When the walls are 2 to 4 bricks thick, then diagonal bond is suitable. The bond is introduced in the masonry work at regular vertical internal, normally at 5th or 7th course. Here one thing note that the direction of bricks are reverse in the every alternate course of the bond. Now second type of racking bond is herringbone bond. It is a type of racking bond in which bricks are arranged at 45 degree in the opposite direction from the center of the wall thickness. So here we can see this is the center of the wall thickness, and here bricks are arranged 45 degree in the opposite direction from this center of the wall thickness. Here also one thing note that the direction of bricks are changed in every alternate course, and the bond is introduced at regular internal in the wall. When the walls are thicker than 4 bricks thick, then herringbone bond is quite suitable. This type of bond can also be used for brick flooring and for ornamental finish to the frontage of wall. So this image shows actual picture of herringbone bond. Now we will discuss about special features of racking bond. So there are 4 special features of racking bond, and these are, first one is the bricks are laid at an inclination in the space between the external stretchers of the wall. Racking bond is provided at a regular interval of 4 to 8 courses in the height of wall, but this type of bond never be provided in successive courses. Third point is inclination or racking is taken in opposite direction in alternate courses of racking bond. And last point is, so as to make the bond more effective and attractive, the racking course is generally provided in between the two stretcher courses of the wall in which thickness is equal to even multiple of half brick. So here we can see this is actual picture of wall in which racking bond is provided. So here this video is finished. I hope this video will be helpful for you. For more updates, subscribe my channel and don't forget to share this video with your friends.